You know, every time it happens, we hear from investigators or family members. But today, Fox 10 News reporter Devin Cafaro is sitting down with these teens in Metro Jail to get their side.
Put the guns down! Stop the violence today!
A community crying out for change.
One teenager is dead and another one is in jail.
Whose gun it was or how the teens got it?
Many questions with very few answers.
I'm sorry, you ain't supposed to go like that.
What was supposed to happen?
Not that.
So we went to Metro Jail, three 17-year-olds.
I'm Devin. I'm gonna mic you up real quick.
Three different charges.
Elijah McKinley, and I'm charged with robbery first.
Demetrius Hunzon being charged with assault second and shooting to occupy a vehicle.
Noah Jones and murder.
All of them put behind bars this year. We couldn't ask about their cases because they're still pending, but we did ask about the road they took to get here.
Why did you feel the need to have a gun?
All of them had the same answer.
One reason was for protection, but second reason, like, I guess it would have made me feel like a man.
My area where I stayed at, and something was going on, we were getting robbed, and stuff happening, shootouts and fights and all that. You know, I just feel safer with a gun.
People just try to get strikes. Sometimes they'll just shoot at you for no reason.
Murder suspect Noah Jones got his gun at a young age.
My first gun, seventh grade.
Seventh grade? How old are you?
About 13.
For $100 or less, all three of these teens bought their guns off the street, many of them stolen and many of them from other teens. They say they always made sure to keep their guns hidden from parents.
Put it outside or put it under my bed or keep it at my friend's house.
Not outside the house, like probably in the bushes somewhere or under the house or something like that.
Do you remember what it felt like when you held your first gun?
It felt like power.
Felt like power?
Yeah, like you ain't scared of nobody.
And that power can be addicting, they say, especially when so many other teens with guns are bullies. Assault suspect Demetrius Hunter recalls a time he had to fire his gun to protect himself from a group of men when he was walking home.
What was going through your mind in the moment you pull a trigger?
I didn't want to die. I was scared.
They say it's a vicious cycle. Many teens unable to get out until it's too late and making the problem worse. They say it's music that glorifies gun culture.
NBA Youngboy, he made a song called 38, baby. Everybody seen on Facebook, a lot of them trying to get 38s. Just because of him.
People just want to be like that. People just want to live that lifestyle. They think that's the way to live. But once you get back here, it don't matter what you did or how you did it, you'll be a nobody back here. It ain't going to be worth throwing your life away.
And tomorrow we'll continue this conversation with those teens, Lanise, asking them what they think parents and community members can do to stop this epidemic.
You know, it really is an interesting conversation. I'm curious, though, in retrospect, did any of these guys talk about what they would do differently if they had an opportunity to go back in time?
They did. It was actually very powerful, and it's one of the reasons why they spoke with me. They want other teams to not follow that same path. So anyone watching tomorrow night, gather your children around the TV tomorrow at 9, because it's a message you'll want to hear.
Definitely a conversation that needs to be had. Thank you, Devin.
12 teens have died from gun violence this year. 11 were arrested.
And that's more than the past 2 years combined. Yesterday, we spoke with teens about that problem. And
today, Fox 10 News reporter Devin Cafaro is asking them about solutions they think will help other teens who are on the same path.
As the number one cause of death so far this year is gunfire for a teenager.
One teenager is dead and another one is in jail.
We see it on the news day after day.
We don't need this violence, killing each other. Stop it.
Another family heartbroken.
I'm sorry, you ain't supposed to go like that.
Another teen on TV headed straight to jail. Part of this disturbing and sometimes deadly trend are robbery suspect Elijah McKinley, assault suspect Demetrius Hunter, and murder suspect Noah Jones. All of them are 17.
If you ain't got a job or you ain't got no money, that's when trouble starts.
Yesterday, they told us how and why teens are getting guns. Today, we're learning more about the regret.
It's not worth it. You can't see your family. You can't do what you want back here. You can't eat how you want on my son's birthday. I called my mama. She called him on three-way to talk to him. I was sad. It hurt me.
but I don't make it up to them when I get out.
I want to finish high school. I need my education. People need education nowadays to get a good job.
For other teenagers getting wrapped up in this, going down this road, what would you tell them?
Put the gun down. It ain't worth it. Stay in school, stay in sports, after school activities. Just find something, just do something better.
Just leave it alone, stay out the streets. Go and get your education, get you a good job.
Put the gun down, you got a problem, walk the other way. Find a job, just stay out of trouble. Don't think a gun will keep you out of trouble, because it only bring more trouble, some trouble that you can't get out.
From someone who's been on the other side of it all, what more can we do as a community to deter this gun culture?
Open up more gyms and playgrounds, you know, something to keep them productive and hang out instead of being on the street. Have a little church day for the youth to come through the weekday, like Bible study.
As for parents, these teens say to keep your children in the house and off the streets, make them do well in school, and check both inside and outside the home for guns. They say teens without strong parental figures should seek guidance from others, like pastors or teachers.
Getting back at somebody is not always the answer. Yeah. Sometimes you have to let stuff go.
But all of them say the change truly has to start from within the teens themselves, by watching the company they keep and looking at others as people, not just someone you need to prove your power to.
What can we do to make teenagers listen to that message? Because sometimes, like you said earlier, they're going to do what they want to do.
Just stay on them. Don't give up on them. Everybody got some good in them. You got to know how to bring it out.
And it took a lot of courage for those teens to come forward and talk with us. And they say that's exactly what other teens need, courage to stand up against this deadly trend before more lives are lost. Bob, Lanise.
Okay, Devin, I understand the sheriff's office and the DA's office are trying to start a new program to help teens, right?
That's right. Women from both the sheriff's office and the DA's office were there during our interviews taking notes that will help them establish this new program. Of course, there are several other programs already aimed at helping teens, and we'll put all the information for you on our website.